Our floor manager, I want to strangle. Could you just move back a little bit and just, like, not be such a part of the show? Do me a favor, just move back a little bit.
I left back a little bit.
He wants to be a member of the crew.
Yeah, it's real annoying. He's telling me what's working, what isn't working. I don't need another rider. I already got two bums riding. I got Moe and Larry. I don't
need
Curly.
He's as productive as they are.
Yeah, right. I tell you. You know, it's... Do me a favor. Move back. Seriously. I can't take it. You're in my face. That's terrible. It really is. He's a nice guy and everything, but he's trying a little too hard.
You're making me feel bad. Now, right? Stop that.
Go to the green room with the rest of the guests. Go there with Judy Tenuta. She's in there. Goodbye. Very good. We are deluged with mail.
Deluged?
Deluged. What is deluged? Deluged, isn't that right?
No.
We are...
Deluged?
No, it's deluged, yeah.
Deluged, yeah.
Ah, we're so swamped. I don't know
That's
anything.
Right.
We're swamped.
Inundated.
We're inundated with news. I mean, mail, something. Hey, and by the way, if you write us, send us a photo, you women out there, if you want to be a spokesmodel on our show, and in 50 words or less, tell us why you want to be a spokesmodel, and send it to spokesmodel, care of Howard Stern Show, 9 Broadcast Plaza, Secaucus, New Jersey, 07096. Look at this mail. Now, let me go through all this. First of all, this guy, this one guy sends us every week a $10 bill.
For what?
It just says, I want to give Robin a spanking. All right? And he encloses $10 bills.
Oh, how much money have I made so far?
We've made $50 so far. He just wants to give you a spanking. And I'm thinking that if that guy would just send us a phone number, hey, you would go for it, wouldn't you? Yeah, you like that.
Not for 50.
Not for 50?
He's got to do a lot better than that.
Keep sending in those 10. I find that fascinating. Now, there's a guy who last week sent in Gary's headgear.
Right.
It was a beautiful piece, too.
It was really nice because it shielded your entire mouth.
125 degrees, shielding at all angles.
And here he is. He's coming here, and he's got a whole new device with him. Come on in. He's a little nervous.
Wow, so nice to see you.
Hey, how you doing? Now, where do you live? Sit down.
Real pleasure.
Real quick.
Gary.
Don't be mad. And you called the other one a gun blocker, right?
Yeah, the other one was a gun blocker 2000. This unit here is, to solve Gary's... licking problem.
Because he's always licking his teeth.
Have you noticed the problems he has?
Oh, yes. So, watching the show week over week, they say, Willie, can't you do something about that?
Well, Gary's is convinced that his teeth do not look funny on camera.
Well, if you go back and take a couple clips.
Right. Now, what do you do for a living that you know how to do all this
stuff? Oh, I'm a truck mechanic.
So yeah. You're in the mechanical field. Now, you built a helmet here that I see has a device on top.
What is that?
Now, what does this device do?
Well, the whole unit is called a personal irrigation spraying system, as I wrote you in the letter.
Right.
We won't go into the acronym of that, but...
Don't be a comedian. Hey, what's your name, by the way?
Willie.
Willie.
William Morofsky.
All right, Willie. Like, we're supposed to know that.
Well, the people out there don't know. We know.
Willie. We knew that, Willie.
Oh.
I didn't read your letter. We have people who read your letter. Now, in other words, put this on Gary's head.
Yeah, you ever put this...
it has its own water supply and everything.
Oh, yeah, there's a reservoir built in.
The beauty of all this.
Now, okay, that's the helmet. And now, where does the irrigating system go?
All right, if we can get a shot from this side, maybe you want to use your telestrator on this.
All right, go ahead. I can help you with that. Now, this, in other words, what we're talking about now is this power pack right here. What is that?
Well, this is the reservoir right here.
That's the water.
That's the water reservoir.
Right here.
Or whatever beverage of your choice.
Right, so that's that.
Jackie, maybe you want to use this later with a little beer or something.
All right, now this device up here will spray the water into Gary's mouth.
Yeah, this is a high-powered nozzle.
Right, the high-powered nozzle will irrigate his giant caps and teeth.
Yeah.
And it won't get him wet?
It may get him slightly wet if we got a bucket or something.
Isn't it worth getting wet so it will be irrigated?
Can I put it a little closer or no?
No, it'll reach.
All right, now where is the button that I can press?
It's a self-contained unit with a wired remote.
Now, anytime I see Gary's teeth getting dry or I see a licking action in this area, I can spray right in.
Absolutely.
Right, like that. Let me clear this so you can see. Get a tight shot on there. Let me see how this works. And I can constantly spray and irrigate right in there. I see.
Oh, beautiful!
Yes. Constantly. Well, that's very nice.
We can also recycle the water.
The water can be recycled into here.
Put it
very
back
nice.
Into the reservoir.
Oh,
there
my
he goes.
Goodness.
Oh, that's very exciting.
Oh, look, someone put a cigarette
drowning.
In here.
That's very, very nice. Okay, so.
Oh, man.
Very, very good. All right. Let me, by the way,
unfortunately, we can see him with this apparatus.
Or something here. Did you put fluoride or something in
It wasn't fluoride.
Can you put some Snapple in? What is in there, actually? Is it just water?
Oh, yeah, it's just water.
Can you put Snapple in there, my favorite
absolutely.
Drink?
get a bottle.
Let me have those bottles.
Here you go, Howard.
Boy, that's a fascinating invention. Really is, and I think that's going to help Gary a lot.
I like the...
Pour some Snapple in there and let's see what happens.
I'm a big fan of the iced tea.
Gary's a huge iced tea fan, and I'll tell you why. First of all, it's all natural. Snapple drinks are all natural. If you notice this drink, you're saying, well, if it's all natural, it looks like there's artificial coloring in this one. This is just the natural color of the cherry in here. The cherry. Do you understand, Robin?
The cherry's in there?
The cherry is in here.
I thought I lost it. No.
No, you didn't lose your cherry. You did not lose your cherry. The cherry is here, and I'm very glad. Although, I remember when you were 7, you lost your cherry. And
I got it back.
You got your cherry back, and all was well. Shut up, Gary. All right, now, let me see something. If we take a look at Snapple, which is a cherry lime, this is all natural. There's no artificial coloring. There are no artificial ingredients. This is healthy. This is something you want to give your kids.
Oh,
whether
that's
it's
Grape Aid.
This
I didn't
is
know
Grape
what
Aid,
was.
And this one is their sports drink Snap Up, which is great, which really gives you that extra boost while you're working out. And there's nothing artificial. A lot of the sports drinks have artificial things in it. Is the iced tea loaded into
Absolutely.
Gary? All right. So now watch the iced tea. This is all natural, made from the best stuff on earth. Here you go, Gary. Touchdown. That is actual iced tea going in. How is it, Gary? Get Snapple now. It's made from the best stuff on earth.
Yeah.
What a show tonight.
All right.
I can't wait to get Judy Tenuta out here because I think Judy's got a tight little body underneath all that stupid costuming, don't you?
I think you got the hots for her all of a sudden.
I don't know, but we do a great Roseanne sketch because I hate Roseanne now and so does Judy. And,
yeah.
And why don't we bring her out? We'll explain everything to you.
Yeah.
Judy? Yeah.
Wait, I want to feel you.
Come on in here.
Look at this outfit.
Nice outfit, Judy. You look real feminine.
Thank you.
You know what it is? It's funny,
Where
though.
Where do you get your clothes?
Judy doesn't have a bad little body. You don't have a bad body.
Take off my clothes.
You don't have a bad body.
It's the way you dress.
You don't have a bad body. But
Here, I brought these for you, honey.
What is that?
A G-string.
Yeah, good. I'll wear that.
Stop it. Come
it's
on.
Your color,
Put it in
too.
Your mouth. Hey, seriously, sit down for a second.
I'll put it on.
Judy hates Roseanne a whole bunch.
Now, why does she hate Roseanne?
Hey, I understand the guy who dresses you came with you. If I was him, I'd hide.
Oh, why?
There's somebody responsible for this?
First of all, I've been saying this on the radio. We're on the radio in the morning, in case you don't know that, on 92.3 K-Rock. Stand up. Stand up.
What's wrong?
It's like, you got a decent body. You see, like, doesn't this look...
It looks like he's hiding
something.
Turn
to camera three. You see,
no!
You turn to camera three. Seriously.
Oh, wait!
Turn to camera three. Now, you see... Come here. Turn around.
What is he doing?
Wait a minute. I want to see
Get the hair out of your mouth. All right. No, seriously. Just turn around. I want to show you something. Turn around.
No, I know what you're going to do.
No, I promise I won't squeeze anything.
You're
I won't squeeze anything.
Big bun.
No, look. You see over here? Doesn't it look like she has like a lot of
cellulite?
Yeah,
it looks like there's something in there.
But well, look. See? Look how tight it is.
Look at that.
Look how tight it is.
You just want to grab
Look how tight
her.
It is. Look how tight.
And she always stands there and lets you. That's what I don't
understand. Look how tight. Got tight. No, really, it's nice and tight. Well, show everybody. You got a nice body. Pull down your pants.
Pull them down.
Oh, it's tight. And look at your belly. Hey, stand up for a second. Look,
wait,
stand
there
up.
There are clothes coming off. What are you doing to her?
Stand up for a second. You see over here? Look how nice and tight her belly is. Look how nice and tight. But you can't tell in these pants. Go ahead, sit
I guess
down.
You don't like the way she dresses.
Yeah, unbelievable.
I'm a fashion fox, and so is Robin. Look at Robin.
All right, listen. I want to tell you, first of all, that Judy will be taping her HBO special.
Showtime!
At the round... Oh, Showtime?
Showtime! Oh. The HBO. Showtime!
Woo! Fall final!
To too bad.
Bowling
Molly,
fingers.
Wait a second. Here's the, give me that cue card. Don't cross that out. Give me that. This is what it says here, HBO.
I know, but it's Showtime, Howard.
Showtime, the runner-up to HBO.
Oh, nice
oh,
one.
Oh, it is. It
Who
is.
Who took these notes?
You would rather have it, HBO. You would rather have an HBO special, though, wouldn't you? Than a Showtime
special? Oh, yes, yes. I'd like to be Louis Anderson.
Yeah, right.
Oh.
Judy will be taping her HBO, or a Showtime special.
Look
at the
you.
Roundabout Theater this Monday at 7:30.
I'm just looking. You got lipstick on your nose,
well,
on your mouth.
Let me just say something. Judy does a Roseanne sketch. First of all, let me say something. We've been reading in the Inquirer.
Just wipe your face.
Oh, wait.
It's amazing.
It looks good like that.
I need a little color in my lips. We've been reading, seriously.
Yes, sir.
We've been reading in the Inquirer mm-hmm. that fat Roseanne and her fat, disgusting husband
said something nasty about you.
That said something nasty about me in the Inquirer. They were on the radio. I have no axe to grind with them.
You never said a word about it.
You're just telling the truth. I mean, people that moon in public, like, how can you ignore it?
Well, personally, those two fat, disgusting slobs who make fun of our national anthem.
That's right.
Right? They don't deserve success, right? But here's the point I want to make. We do a sketch today. We read in the Inquirer that Tom Arnold is taking money from the Inquirer and all that other stuff.
Yeah, now they're suing, but he admits to cashing a couple of checks.
I don't really believe all that stuff, but we did a parody of it anyway. We did a parody, right, that said, what if Tom Arnold really was taking her money, and what if he really married her for her money? I mean,
which is hard to believe.
Which I don't really think happened.
They look like they're in love, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh. They look like they're really, truly in love. Any guy would marry a big, fat pig like that.
Isn't that the person you'd be searching for?
Yeah, exactly.
I think, he respects her as a slab of meat.
Yeah, exactly. So anyway, Judy does a great dead-on Roseanne.
Yes, she does.
And you'll be Grossanne. Well, actually, we taped it already. Is it funny?
It's very
exciting.
Funny. I can't wait to see it.
We got
to
watch it back together.
Yeah. Oh, could we?
Yes, we really could.
I'm in a hemorrhage.
That's unbelievable. And Judy will, where's the guy who designs those outfits? Seriously, you have such a tight body. You got to be, how big are your breasts?
What is the purpose of this?
Your breasts are big. Your breasts are real big and everything.
They are not.
No, they're nice. 34 what, B?
Yeah.
All right, B, you see? But, I guess I guess, yeah, okay.
Come out here, Rich. Come out.
The guy's embarrassed. That's you? That's you? Hey, dude.
What?
Do you like women? Do you have any respect for the female form?
What?
You're making her into a fat pig. It looks like she's got thighs the size of a horse.
Dream on, tampon.
All right, get out of here. What's the matter with you? By the way, that's number one son, in case you're wondering what happened. Remember him from that Charlie Chan, Robin? Hey, Judy, let me measure your head. She has a big head. Let me just say that.
Let me measure your crotch.
Yeah, go ahead. Measure it, honey. Like, you don't want it. All right, wait a second. We'll measure Judy's head after the sketch.
Yeah, right.
After this break with a tape measure for Judy's head.
Let me tell you about the brother fax machine, all right?
Oh, God. That was smooth, Howard.
This is a great fax machine. Well, where are my faxes? Oh, here they are.
This is a real professional show.
I got the fax here.
The big brother.
Brother fax machine is 200, is really great. It's reasonably priced. I own one, and it's easy to use. Where's our spokesmodel?
Oh!
Oh, here she is.
Whoa!
Oh, come on over here. Here's our
Wait
spokesmodel.
A minute.
Hi, what's your name?
My name's Topsy Curvy.
Topsy Curvy is here.
Come
on up. Step right up.
Are you real?
Here, now hold the fax machine.
Are you for real?
You better believe it. Wait, can I see
you
this?
You touch me, and I'll knock you out. Honey.
Oh, bitch! Yeah!
Judy. Let me just see.
Gross.
I'm not going to touch him. I just want to see.
Not.
Wow, look at the
goodness.
Size of you. Yeah. And those are all yours. You're not artificially.
No.
You're not.
And you never thought of having those fixed.
You don't want those fixed?
Going to the bank every week with all the money that
I
make. Is that right? What are you, stripping clubs and stuff?
Well, I'm burlesque.
Burlesque star?
Then she strips.
She talks like Ted Kennedy. I'm a burlesque star.
I'm from Boston.
You are from Boston. Look at all the... Hey, you point to the fax machine with your breasts. Point to the fax machine.
Yeah, you don't need a pointer.
No, just, point and be a spokesmodel, okay? Topsy-curvy.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Topsy-curvy. Here we go. You just point to stuff, all right? Go ahead. Be a spokesmodel.
Well, tell her to just lean into it.
Can you lean into it?
No, I can't.
Why?
I don't choose to.
You don't choose to?
No.
All right, well, okay. All right.
You wanted a model, Howie?
Yeah.
Well, behave yourself.
Okay, here we go. I got some faxes.
You know, even strippers on this show
have an attitude.
Don't know
they have an attitude.
What you wanted to do.
Judy, show her how to spokesmodel. Point to stuff and do all that, you know?
You know, lay on it.
Lay on the fax machine.
Get your head down there so you're in the picture.
There you go.
Oh, there you go.
Go ahead. Show some shoulder.
See, I'm real, so I can do it.
Let me tell you about this.
Oh!
Are you real, honey?
Hey, look at this. I just got a fax. I just got a fax from the Guinness Book of World Records. It says, how big is Judy Tenuta's head?
Oh,
you're so cute.
That sounds a bit not too big.
Not too big?
Oh.
Oh.
Woo, you cut me to the quick.
Anyway. This has great features.
Good. I've got Dolly Parton's afterbirth, and I have to deal with it.
Oh, have you looked in the mirror lately? I mean, how can you criticize me when you look like
you
do?
Oh, you're right. You look so natural.
Oh, well.
Barbie.
Well, what can I say? You said I have to wear glittery things. So
what do you call this?
It's a blouse. What do you call
boobs.
That? It's
all right.
Boobs.
These are weapons.
Weapons.
All right, now.
You better get them enlarged.
I use this.
Yeah. If you want to use those for weapons, you better enlarge them.
Excuse me, I don't want to breastfeed Guatemala, okay? Do you mind? What's
it Yes.
Honey, I can't help it. You got cheated. I just can't help it.
All right.
You see,
is it stopped?
Oh, yes.
All right. You guys sound very angry. Very angry.
I'm not angry. I'm very happy. Like I said, I go to the bank once a week.
All right. Very good. You're in the bank. Okay. Here we go, Topsy Wervy. All right.
Dropsy Curvy.
Dropsy Curvy? Topsy Curvy.
This show is over. I have to go.
Home. This show is over? Goodbye. Okay. Goodbye, Topsy Curvy. Goodbye. All right. Don't go away. Grossanne is next.
Come.
Oh, oh, honey. I'm so happy we got married and stuff.
Me too, honey.
Oh, I love you so much. I can't stand to be away from you.
That's why I love going to the can with you. I love to be near you.
Your smell. Oh, it's like perfume to me. I love your your Glom Arnold B.O.
There's one thing I love more than being in a bathroom with you, and that's eating you up and eating with you. Come on, let's see.
Oh, yeah.
Wipes the gas.
See. Okay. Uh-huh. Oh, man.
Turkey.
I love eating with you, huh?
I do too. Hey, honey, I hate the Enquirer. They're such slobs.
Ah, they're slobs. I hate them too.
Oh, I hate them because they keep accusing you of marrying me for my money and stuff.
Yeah, that's wrong. I hate the Enquirer. I want to kill them.
Yeah, hey. Oh, honey, I gotta go to the can again.
You gotta go to the can again? Ah, uh-huh. Grossy, go ahead.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Go ahead.
Okay, honey. I'll miss you.
I'll miss you. Roseanne never knew I was going through a pocketbook to kill me. Whoa! Hey, Roseanne, honey, how you doing in there?
This one's a real paint pillar.
You just take your time. I'm waiting here for you. Hello, Enquirer. Listen, I have a tape recorder all set up. I got pictures of that big fat slob eating in every position. Hey, what would you pay for a picture of Grossanne on the can? Really? Okay. Hey, I gotta go. She's gonna want me in the can with her. Hey, send my check to the post office box and not my house. How you doing, honey, in there, all right?
Uh-huh,
hold
honey.
On, pumpkin, I'm coming in with you, all right? You just hold on now.
Oh, yeah, I miss you, honey.
You just wait for your little pumpkin to come in there with you.
Oh, honey.
Where the hell is my camera?
Oh, honey.
Where is my camera?
Oh. Oh, honey, I miss you. Oh! Honey, what was that?
Lightning. Not till this little red light comes on, honey.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Grossanne, did you wash your hands?
Oh, why should I? They're not that dirty and stuff.
No. Okay, where's that? Come here. You need some potatoes, you little. You're such a fox. I love you. Gravy is so good. I love it. Don't you? I do, too. Hey, where's that script I was reading? Sweetheart, where's your script? Huh? The hell is wrong with you?
Oh, honey.
You know what I was doing? I was just going over your TV show to make sure it's funny.
Oh, honey. You're so involved in crap.
Someone's got to watch out for your career.
Oh.
Don't look at me as your husband. Think of me as executive producer Tom Arnold. That sings to me. Look, I'm not hanging around here for the beauty pageant.
Oh, honey, I know you have a career to nourish. Hey, speaking of nourish, come on, let's eat. Let's eat, honey.
Mm.
Oh, goody.
Wait a second. I have something to do first. My first executive decision.
Oh, that's my tiger.
All right, work first, honey.
Yeah. Oh. You're so different than my first pig husband. Oh. What's he so sore about, honey? I mean, all he ever did for me was stick with me through the dark days and nurture my career and help me through my breakdown. And now he's whining.
Hello, John Goodman? This is Glom. 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 Arnold. Grossanne's husband. Yeah, how you doing? Hey, look, this week's show, Grossanne divorces you and marries me. What do you think of that, yeah? Yeah? Well, the same to you.
Oh, what's he saying, honey?
He's saying he doesn't like it. Hey, go play Fred Flintstone in that stupid movie, you no-fat talent jerk. He'll never work in this business again. Sure, honey.
Ah!
I love your butt. Oh, I love you. I'm so happy with you. Hey, I tell you, being executive producer is hard work. Let's eat.
Oh, Mom. Oh, yeah.
What?
Oh,
you look like you have to make a bowel movement.
Yeah,
again. Hey, you go ahead, honey. Go ahead. It's all right. We'll eat when you get back. Go ahead. You go make a bowel movement, and then we'll eat.
Okay, I'm going to go take a dump now.
All right, very good. You go ahead, honey. I'm waiting right here for you.
Okay.
Pull yourself together. Hello, Inquirer? Yeah, hey, listen. How much would you pay for nude pictures of my sloppy wife in action? That much? Okay. Send the check. Right. E.O. Right. And this time, put on it, executive producer, Glom Arnold. Ciao. Honey, let's make love.
Come
here. Yeah, let's make love.
Oh, you do love me. Oh, honey. Oh, 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 oh,
thank you.
Say, we got a floor manager. He's having sex with me under the desk.
Isn't that what you always wanted?
I did want that, I'll tell you the truth. Let me just check your cap, Gary, make sure it's working properly, okay?
Drink.
Yeah, go for it.
All right.
Do you have to yell out drink during that? You're becoming too much a part of the show. Drink.
You don't join in, okay?
All right, I'm just having too much fun with this button. There's too much control here, man. It's just beautiful.
Oh,
sorry. Sorry. Oh.
Will you stop?
I can't help it. I can't stop myself.
You're hurting the boy.
Hey, Robin, what's in the news, by the way?
Well, you know, Howard, I was reading Mariette Hartley's book, and you were just complaining about being hungry. I understand from her book that Purina Cat Chow is a nice little snack.
Yeah.
You want to try some of that?
You know, Mariette Hartley wrote a book and said, like, what did she become, like, bulimic or something?
No, she was an alcoholic, and she just used to eat everything in sight. And when nothing else, I guess, was in sight, she'd eat the Purina Cat Chow, too.
You know,
I thought we ought to try it.
Oh, man.
Come on.
Feed it to Gary. It goes good with his little cat.
This is exactly what she ate. You've been complaining of hunger?
I don't know about this. You know what I mean?
Come on, try it. Tell me what it tastes like.
Can I put some water on it so we get gravy? All right, I'll tell you.
What does it smell like? I don't even know what it smells like.
It smells like Gary's breath.
Ooh.
All right, here we go.
You're really eating it.
Meow. You know, it's not that bad.
It's not bad?
No, it's not that bad.
Because you told me you ate dog bones before.
Yeah, and I started licking myself.
What will he do now?
Man, it's gross. Oh, it's got an aftertaste that won't quit. Wait a second. I got a fur ball.
Oh, yuck. Well, I didn't bring anything to clean that up.
No, sorry. Oh, it's gross.
Ooh, it really has an aftertaste?
Yeah, it has a bad aftertaste.
Ooh, what are you going to... What's that on your breath?
Kiss me.
Well, anyway, Howard.
Don't try that at home.
That's right. We're experts here. Two Live Crew has been in the news because they're on trial in Florida.
Those jerks.
For obscenity.
Good, lock them in jail. Who needs them? They look like they're up to no good anyway. I don't say lock them in jail for their lyrics, but I'll tell you something. They look like they committed a few crimes.
Well, let's take a look. You know, we'll see a little bit of that performance down in Florida, and let's see how much we can get through without having to cut it off.
I hope this isn't indecent. Here we go. Hey, you know, I heard they sold over 2 million albums, man. Why not fix this tooth right here? You know what I mean? Come on, what's going on?
Okay, yeah. Well, that was them performing, and Luther, when he ran into all this trouble, he decided that maybe what he ought to do is make his albums differently, start writing different songs. See what he says.
All right, let's see what he says.
What I'm going to start doing, you know, is I'm going to start making, instead of making a clean version and an adult version, I'm going to make a black version and a white version. You know, I'm going to start saying, let's get laid and let's do her and things like that.
All right. Sounds like a pretty good concept
to
me.
That'll fix everything, right?
What, to him, melody is a dirty word. Now, you can't... let me tell you something about this guy. The more I look at this picture here, Robin...
Yeah.
I mean, you can't tell me that he would look bad like this. Behind bars. He looks like he's been committing crime, I tell you. He looks like it. You put the bars in and then you don't worry about
Luther,
him anymore.
That's the future.
Yeah,
okay.
Right,
also, Howard, you know, our mayor has been taking quite a battering from the press, you know, with the headboard.
Because he's an idiot.
This and that.
I want to squirt Gary. I want to squirt Gary. Gary, show us how Dinkin sweats. Move that thing up a little higher. Show us how Dinkin sweats. Just shoot that. That's it. Move it up higher.
Oh, no.
That's how our mayor sweats.
Is our mayor sweating now, Howard?
Yeah.
He's getting a little testy. Put in the tape.
All right. Let's see our mayor. For God's sake.
Poor Gary. I'm spitting. Oh.
Anybody want more of the cat food?
Here we go. Here's Mayor Dinkins. He was,
right.
confronted by some reporters.
You know I'm
going to do it. Okay, but two kids were shot today, Mayor. We just wanted to ask you a little bit.
Why didn't you ask me? Let me just sit down.
Whoa.
Whoa, hey,
watch this in slow motion. We'll see what the mayor does. He's starting to go into the elevator. Then he comes back up shaking his finger and get out of here.
Now, wait a second, Robin. I need to take a look at this. And this, let me show you one shot that I think is kind of interesting on this video. Right here, I would say he looks like a tired waiter. Or it looks like Minister Farrakhan has visited him right around here.
Yes, this is true.
Maybe it's time to get some religion going, you know? Some good Jew-hating and religion.
Everything would straighten right out.
I'll tell you that.
So anyway, he seems a little testy right now, don't you think?
Yes, he really does. Why was he so upset? What's the matter? He can't answer a few questions?
He's tired of that headboard because they started with that.
Oh, it's time to break for commercial, Robin.
Excuse us?
God, are we working this show or what? Let me talk to you. Now, listen, Brother Fax called up. They're very upset with our last commercial. Judy Tenuta totally ruined it. And that big, what was that name? Dusty Lusty?
I don't know. Curvesy Wervesy? I don't know what her
name was. The one with the big breasts. I never saw a stripper.
Topsy Turvy?
Topsy Fatsy Breasty. All right. I love this fax machine. I cannot tell you. This brother company is unbelievable. I use this fax machine at home. I use it every day. I get faxes like this all the time. Squirt Gary Moore, signed everyone.
Oh!
There's my button. Look at that.
That was the fax you got?
Let me just squirt you now, right now. I'm squirting you. There you are. There you go. Let me explain to you about this fax machine and why I like it so much. It has a couple of features that I think are worthwhile. First of all, if you notice here, there is an LCD display. Very few fax machines have that. That way you can't dial a wrong number. You'll know the number. Then if you look at this cover page here, Monty, with the camera, look at that right there. Hold it steady, okay, pal? Hold it steady, I said. If you look at the cover page right here, you'll notice that this is automatic. Automatically, this will be programmed into your fax machine. There are no fax machines on the market that work like the Brother Fax machine. They have auto feed, auto cut, auto cover page, all right? And it makes for a great holiday gift. I really recommend this one. It's available at Staples, J&R Music World, and Newmark and Lewis. And if you buy another fax machine, I guarantee you within a couple of months, you'll be buying a different one. Robin, don't you think the news would be a lot better if you did it without that jacket on?
What difference does the jacket make?
Hey, come on. I ate the cat food, didn't I?
I'll eat the cat food.
You eat this cat food. No. Just taste this. Eat this cat food. Come on. Come on. Ratings.
There's nothing under here but a regular old dress.
Would you stand up? My sister would like to see your outfit.
I stood up once
Please.
Already.
Wow, look at that dress. Hold it a second. I got to telestrate you. Take a look right here. Very nice. Wait a second. We pan down there? Yes. Go back, please. Well, first of all, if this was cut lower, this would really get us ratings.
You can cut it lower. There's nothing there.
Yes, take it down. And, of course, let's pan up your legs. And notice that, the audience can see.
They don't know what legs are on this show.
Monty, you are a hell of a cameraman. Look at that, guys, huh? Let's clear that up. Notice there's no hair on that leg. And as we travel up... All right, more news.
You're so silly.
You can tell I'm totally carried away with this machine. I'm looking for anything to draw on, okay?
Well, this will give you something to draw on. You know who's also in the news this week? Madonna.
Madonna.
They just did a bunch of PSAs, that's public service announcements, for MTV. And it's all about getting out that young vote. So, of course, who else but the material girl to get all the young people to vote? Here's a little bit of Madonna's PSA done to her hit Vogue.
Hey, Madonna, you want to do a public service announcement? Weld your legs together, sweetheart. Eh?
Maybe she does that. Let's see.
I don't know. I don't know what she does. Here we go.
Dr. King, Malcolm X, freedom of speech is as good as sex. Don't give up your freedom of speech. Power to the people is in our reach.
Whoop. Whoa.
What is going on there?
Well, let's see. Let's take a real good slow look here, okay? Well, we could use a little work in here, couldn't we? What do you think, Robin?
I said to myself, now here's a woman who has a personal trainer.
Right.
And works out 7 or 8 hours a day from what we understand.
And
what
still,
is going on?
She got a belly like a heifer. She got a belly like a heifer, for crying out loud. What is that? Supergirl with these giant panties. Let's get a short little thong going there, honey. Let's lose the Harpo Marx haircut, all right? That's out. Well, you know, like that, she don't look so bad. And you cover that up. Man, that's not
now
bad at all.
All right.
Lose these jack boots. What are we, Nazi Germany?
And what are those two guys standing around her?
What is this, a potato in your pants? All right.
Nice outfits,
nice
boys.
Outfits, boys.
Also, Howard, you know who's always in the news?
Fred Norris.
No.
I'm going to tell you something. You know, the more I look at this Madonna picture, forgive me for indulging myself. Hey, just excuse me for a second. Put this on, will you? The more I look at it,
yeah.
The guy on the left here has nicer legs than her. Take a look at that. Look at the nice shape.
You know, if you
shape.
Look really closely, you find a lot of things.
You find a lot of things in that picture. I just can't stop drawing on Madonna.
Well, let me tell you. A guy who's always in the news is Al Sharpton.
Yes.
Reverend Al makes the news just about every week.
He sure does.
And because I see him so often, I'm getting kind of tired of that look.
Yeah, it's the same look week after week.
Yeah. So let's take a look at him.
Something tells me I'll be drawn again.
Here he is in the Bronx or the Brooklyn.
Mr. Stewart certainly does not feel he looked intimidating. With my oval angelic face, there's no way I could look intimidating.
But that's a look he's had for a long time.
Right.
What
tired
about
of that.
Changing it? Buckwheat. Like, that's a good
like
look.
Like a nice hat like that?
Yeah. You know, what would Reverend Al look? Ooh.
Ooh.
That could work. How about Farrah Fawcett? She got a good look.
Ooh, I like that.
Well, what about Elvis?
Let me see. Very
that's
nice.
That's not bad. That's
not bad.
Bad
at all.
Larry from the Three Stooges?
Larry Fine. Oh.
How about Howard Stern? That's a good look.
Hey, yeah. Very nice.
Or maybe something a little more conservative by producer Dan Furman. Yes, I think we got a match.
Wait a second. I really like that a lot. Let me just say, what? Me worry?
Oh, man.
All right. Yes. Very nice.
Oh, goodness. And finally today, Howard.
Yes.
Remember Nadia Comăneci?
Yeah.
The beautiful little Romanian gymnast.
Hey, Robin, why am I yelling?
I don't know. I'm sitting right here.
All right, go ahead.
She was such a cute little girl.
Yeah, she was.
Let's take a
She
look.
Was nice. I knew she'd grow up nice. Well, she did look like she was going to be real cute when she grew up.
Well, let's take a look. Here's
let's take
some
a look at
old
her.
Pictures of... Yeah, there she is. Very,
very
cute.
Very cute. Very nice. Whoa.
Look at
yeah,
that.
Baby.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah, I love it. I love to stop it and watch it.
Ooh, and yeah. Now here she is today.
That's her? Feed her a carrot. Feed her a carrot.
Now, what is that I see?
Whoa, wait a second. Time for that telestrator. Now, I don't know. You don't have to be a genius to see that right here is a mustache. A big mustache. Hey, we have depilatory in this country. It's not Romania, honey. She's got a thicker mustache than Gary.
Oh, boy.
Gary, let's spray you.
Yeah!
Like I was shot out of a cannon, I'm doing this show, I tell you. Yeah.
And Howard.
Yes.
That's what's happening.
That's what's happening. We got to take a break. We'll be right back. Don't go away. Hey, Robin, you think that's going to scare people, this
yeah,
picture?
Yeah, you better not keep that up to too long, Howard.
You think you could land a plane on these eyebrows? Yeah. Go back to Romania. What good are you? What good are you?
She needs a lot of work, a lot of work.
Happy Halloween to you, Nadia. The hell happened to you, my God almighty? What a mess. I thought that gymnastics was supposed to get you in shape.
I don't know. Any of them have turned out too well.
I'll tell you something. It's
what?
Time to go to the Stuttering John segment. Stuttering John involved in big controversy. Did
What's
you hear about
that?
It? Stuttering
what?
John asking for more money on the show.
That's right.
So he said to me today he wasn't going to show up.
Oh, job action.
He was going to take a job action and not show up. You dummy. If you walk off the show, though, where are you going to go?
I could go back to college.
Go back to college. What are you going to do?
What is that, a slowdown? You're here, but you're slowing down?
You think you're going to show up next week?
I'll discuss some things with our radio station and hopefully, you know.
What? Are you going to show up on the TV show next week?
I don't know.
Are you going to be here next week? What
I
if they don't
so.
Give you a raise? Are you going to be here next week?
I'd love to be. I love this.
What happens if
I
they don't give you a raise?
I get my ass kicked for this show. I do anything I want, man.
Well, what are you going to do if they don't give you a raise? Are you going to show up next week?
I don't know, man.
Look, if there's any stutterers out there and want to replace him, we might need you. Just get in touch with us, all right?
Could be an opening.
If you got Tourette's, even better. Could be an opening. I think the station will give you more money. I think WOR's got a lot of money that produces this show. And they're going to give you more money.
I'm not asking.
Don't they believe in us?
What are you asking for?
I'm not asking for a hell of a lot.
How much are you asking for?
I was told not to discuss this kind of thing.
Who said not to discuss it?
Your agent.
My agent said not to discuss it?
He didn't mean with him.
If you're applying for the job, the only requirements are that A, you stutter, and you're stupid. And if you got that, you got the job. Now, I love you, and I hope you stay with the show, man. Let's see your final work, though, if this is it.
This could be it.
This could be it. Now, you went and got Liz Smith. Liz Smith is the gossip, yentering columnist who gets everything wrong. This is a woman who makes book reports for a living. I can't stand her. Every time she writes about me, she prints mistruths. But I thought John was a little rough on her.
Well, let's let the people decide. I did, too. She was at a charity event, and she was being very nice to you.
I'm only doing the questions that you tell me to ask him, you know?
Okay, let's take a look at what you did.
Actually, Dice told me to ask a question, too.
Well, what happened here is we saw Dice Clay on the radio before he went out and asked Liz Smith all these questions.
Dice got him all worked up.
Dice said, "Why don't you ask her why she's such a fat cow?"
And you said, "Yeah, do it.
Well, I got carried away, too.
All right. Okay.
It was the moment.
As long as we know.
I do apologize to Liz Smith, because she was a good sport.
Yeah, she seemed to be trying to take this in the right spirit.
Let me just say this is on the dais. You know, I mean, this is like,
you know,
and they're all set to go here.
You know,
laughing.
Maybe you are irreplaceable.
I would hope so.
Yeah, I tell you that.
I hope so. I love it here.
Here we go.
Liz, how you doing?
I'm okay. How are you doing?
Good. This is for the Howard Stern Show, taped to broadcast. Do you like Howard Stern?
I don't know what you said just then. Let's start over.
This is from the Howard Stern Show, taped to broadcast.
Oh, Howard Stern.
Like Howard Stern?
I love Howard Stern. He's an ornament to New York City.
You think she means that?
An ornament. I don't know what that means.
I think
means.
She's talking about Robin's earring.
Send those resumes to the Howard Stern Show. If you stutter or have Tourette's.
She's wearing a chandelier over there.
Put on Gary's helmet so I can squirt you.
Does the Daily News pay you in money or French fries?
Whoa, I gotta see that stutter again.
Hysterical.
Whoa.
Stern.
You like Howard Stern?
I love Howard Stern. He's an ornament to New York City.
Does the Daily News pay you in
hamburgers?
No, and money or French fries?
They pay me in French fries. I mean, I think it's much better that way, and it's so good for my hip.
Hey, Channel 9, give him the reins. Give him the reins. Give him more money. Look at that guy.
I'm only asking for $200 more. I mean,
$200 more.
I'm not making
on.
That much money now, you know?
Knucklehead.
But of the 20 billion burgers McDonald's sold, what portion of that are you responsible for?
Oh, I don't know, 20,000-30,000, I guess, a year.
Will you be going to Burger King or Wendy's after this?
No, I'm going to stick with McDonald's because they made this wonderful Ronald McDonald House.
Okay, do you sweat more when you're fat or thin?
Do I do what?
Do you sweat more when you're fat or thin?
No, I don't sweat.
Which is... All right,
It was lovely talking to
you. Okay, well,
now, you see... She had really gone along with it up till now. You could have left out the Dice Clay question.
I gotta go for the gusto, man.
Yeah, well.
I gotta outdo every other performance.
I kind of apologize, I guess. Well, look,
I mean, there she is. She's being really nice. She's hanging in. You're insulting her already.
How about all the time she insults you in the paper, you know?
Well, you got a point there.
So,
you know, this...
There you go, man. You gotta
be
able to...
Could you hit the desk one more time?
You gotta be able to take it.
You keep smacking the desk and knocking into the microphone.
No, but you gotta be able to take it if you can dish it out, you know?
Yeah, right. Whatever you said. You know, by the way, give me a tight shot on John's face. You got it. When John starts stammering and stuttering, you got to just watch this area right here because the tongue starts shaking like a mother. It just goes wild. Okay, very nice.
I wanted to ask you, why are you such a fat cow?
Oh!
I don't know. It just seems like a good way to be, don't you think?
Oh, come on.
Oh, man.
Come on.
Put Gary's helmet on him.
Yeah,
Put that helmet on. What's the matter with you?
Oh, man. I need to wet you down.
I need to wet you down, man. I don't believe it. You know, at some point you say to yourself, I'm not going to do that.
Yeah, but we're not sending out a prisoner's judgment.
Guys, I can't believe this.
Mutiny.
That's somebody's
I wish.
That's somebody's grandmother.
Yeah, but
in fact, that's Dr. Joyce's brother's grandmother. Hey,
I'm somebody's son.
All right, here we go.
Wait a second. Gary Smittle's in it.
Good night, everybody. We'll see you. See you next time.
Sorry, man.
Topsy-Curvy and her sister will be appearing in the Dollhouse in New York Christmas week.
Do you think that Sue Simmons is an octoroon?
I don't know what that means. She's a lovely cookie, I'll say that for her.
How many Big Macs... Okay. How many Big Macs can you pound down?
Oh, come on.
All right, thanks. Thanks a lot, Liz. Hey, Al, how are you? How you doing?
Okay.